Whoever the inhabitants were, they were living here against their will. How can I explain what's happening to me? What is the meaning of all this? God's blood, transformation, eternal life. I feel like I'm going through what was written in that inscription. Blood in eyes, like in the well. inhabitants of this village lived at different altitudes. Some even lived inside the water. They used this sort of dam to lower or raise the water level. It seems that each family had to agree somehow to change the water level. I'm amazed at how organized they seem to be, despite them being so primitive. Being trapped here probably made them stronger as a community. It seems that each family had to agree somehow to change the water level. I'm amazed at how organized they seem to be, despite them being so primitive. Being trapped here probably made them stronger as a community. Inhabitants of this village lived at different altitudes. Some even lived inside the water. They used this sort of dam to lower or raise the water level. Whoever the inhabitants were, they were living here against their will. It's quite disturbing to see someone's hand paintings from thousands of years ago. I feel connected to them, somehow. This reminds me of some prehistoric cave paintings, like in the Cueva de las Manos in South America. This civilization used these devices to raise and lower the water level. It's impressive. An altar dedicated to two figures. I can hear them talking to me. Different types of creatures of the same species lived here, but they weren't free. This underwater town is a beautiful place, but it has also seen a lot of suffering. All the island is that way. Beautiful, but dangerous. Danger does not seem to affect me, though. from being happy. What I feel now is the complete opposite of being sick. I feel full of life and energy. Even better than before my illness. Now the water level is really low, so I can access that tunnel. These creatures lived like slaves, all their lives imprisoned and tortured in this place. Was it possible to live a decent life in here? If you've lived all your life in a prison, how would you know that you are a prisoner? Now I can enter this tunnel. This current is quite strong. I wonder where it will take me. Over now. That ladder. Someone set up camp in here. Looks like a means of transportation to get to that sanctuary. seems to show two possible courses of action. One means transformation, and the other means death. What is this? This... Oh my god! Did I almost forget about Harry?
My dear old pal. It's only Cass and me now. I have much to thank her for. Even if our friendship is worn thin due to hunger and fatigue. If she hadn't insisted so much, we'd never have convinced Teharoa. He guided us as we followed the river down from the mountain peak. And that's how we found this entrance. And the mural. Maybe I can't undo what's happening to you, Nora, but I think I can try to become like you. The original inhabitants of this island took slaves to a sanctuary, and there they performed a ritual. Teaharoa said the ritual was madness, and he didn't want any part of it. He and Cass argued, violently. When we woke up the next morning, he had left. I know it sounds strange, but you have to trust me, my love. I know this is going to work, and we can be together. You understand what that means, don't you, Nora? We have a second chance. With more love than ever, Harry.
Harry? What ritual are you talking about? Why on earth would you want to become like me? Please don't be a fool. You don't even know if that ritual of yours is going to work. Somebody painted these symbols on the wall. You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this entrance. A sanctuary? Harry, was that where you went? Oh dear. Poor people. Is this why I'm changing too? So the guide left the expedition. That would explain the workshop on the White Sand Beach, where I arrived. She doesn't seem to care much about Harry. And she doesn't seem to be thinking straight either. Harry, that look on your face. You look deranged. The sun is setting. It is so beautiful. This panel looks different from the others. It's much more elaborate. Transportation to the sanctuary. Sense. Nothing bad is going to happen to me here, as menacing as this place might look. The island, the ooze, those sea creatures. They're just defending themselves, like a wild animal against an unknown threat. That's how they perceived the expedition, like a threat. But I, on the other hand, I wasn't a threat, and I definitely wasn't unknown, was I? They seemed to recognize me, as if I was one of their own. Everything seems so distant now, as if I first stepped on that white beach thousands of years ago. A full moon? It can't be. Yesterday was a new moon. Did I lose track of time, or... Maybe this place isn't subject to the laws of physics. That's the only explanation I can find for this surreal night. It's hard to believe everything is real. Maybe it isn't. Maybe I'll open my eyes sometime and I'll be back in our home in Inglewood and... everything will be as before. My perfectly ordinary life with Harry. My daily routines. My illness. That will be as before, too. And then I'll need to shake off this strange feeling that I have now. Feeling that I don't really belong there anymore. And with there, I don't mean Inglewood, or Boston, or Newburyport. I mean, how is it possible that the strange events of only 2 days on this island makes more sense to me than the life that I've been living for years? There it is. The sanctuary. So is this where you went, Harry? Was this your last stop? Black ooze on a petri dish. My God, this syringe has traces of black ooze. What the hell were you thinking? There are drops of dried blood inside this altar.
These patterns look too familiar.
Another camp. Although it's little more than a few things scattered about.
My dear old pal. I never should have trusted Cass. I thought she cared about you, but she's just mad, obsessed with this place. I can't trust her to help me overcome the last obstacle. This door. I know how to open it. But what I have to do is mix my blood with the black ooze. Am I mad for even considering that? It's the only way we can be together. It has to work, right? All this can't be a coincidence. The ritual is made for the two of us, isn't it, Nora? I wish you could be here to... Damn it. I have to think it over. I can't. Tomorrow. Leave it for tomorrow, damn it. Stop writing.
What are you saying, Harry? Don't you see what the black ooze does, what it did to the doctor? Are you out of your mind? A library? What are you talking about, Harry? It was the blood of these creatures. Some sort of catalyst. Heavens, this dagger looks exactly like the one I have. Goodness, and the gun barrel is empty. A woman's earring stained with blood. My God, Harry, what did you do to her? Trail of blood. Someone was hurt. There's a bullet hole in here. If he's behind that door, I wonder which Harry I'll find. How much would be left of the man I love? And how much of the man who has lost his sanity in this place? I really hope this works. Different doors with different symbols. An eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. The stars are aligned, forming a constellation that I don't recognize. That is not the same sky you can see from Earth. And if that's not the Earth sky, where am I now? Circular stones with strange carved symbols. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? I wonder what this means. Constellations and stars. These people seem to worship otherworldly gods. Shining constellation. I better draw it. Where is this door leading me? They carried these people here to test them, like a challenge of some sort. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges, What was it used for? Those stone statues seem to rotate with this switch. I wonder what this means. All these papers are riddled with incoherent doodles. An eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? Circular stones with strange carved symbols. I wonder what this means. So I have to put my hand inside? Moby Dick. Its pages are hollowed out and its shape is... A camera. It must be Cassandra's. Harry asleep in his tent. What a creepy photograph. Oh my, she sounds completely out of her mind. Let's give it a try. Ouch! Oh! Ah! What was that? Looks like a tattoo, but it isn't. Those are my spots. They've moved. Are aligned, forming a constellation that I don't recognize. That is not the same sky you can see from Earth. And if that's not the Earth sky, where am I now? These icons on the wheel are the same as the constellations I have on my hand. This mural seems to describe a ritual involving blood. A dagger. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? Where is this door leading me? Took them to a throne room. That was the final step in the ritual. What an odd structure, riddled with nooks and crannies and endless stairways. Maybe it only hurts the first time. Ah! The second also hurts. When I arrived on this island, I felt like I was trespassing. But now, I feel like this is where I belong. This place is like a labyrinth. We were submerged in black ichor. Harry seems to be on the brink of madness. But I don't feel the slightest hint of confusion. On the contrary, I feel my mind is more focused.
Again? Seriously?
Ow! That hurt! Again. Black and white figures. good doggies, or dragons, whatever you are. Come on. One more time. All the doors are open, but where is the constellation I need to open the throne room? Another one of those gates. I have to get into the water again. Again? Seriously? Ow! That hurt! Again. Feel the torment of the thousands of slaves who perished here. sanctuary's open. It's time to find out what's waiting for me inside. What a disturbing mirror. Is it made of black ichor? I feel like it is... He's speaking it to me. Oh, heavens. God. Nothing that happens here appears to respect the most basic rules of physics. However, as strange as it may be, it does maintain a peculiar harmony. Things of a clock. Or a music box. Harry, is that you? No, 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 no! Tell me this is you, Harry. It can't be you. It can't be... You perform the ritual. You poor fool. But why? I don't understand it. Why? You knew it. You knew it wasn't going to work. You knew the ritual wasn't going to work. That's why you never sat on the throne. You didn't even perform the ritual, did you, Harry? But you wanted me to think that you had. You even left a lure to confuse me. But why? What really happened? The only person with you in that sanctuary beach was Cassandra. So if you didn't die, it had to be her. Did she use the dagger to open the gates and carry out the ritual? You tried to stop her, but it was too late. She shot you with your own gun and left you for dead, didn't she, Harry? Because Cassandra was ambitious and would stop at nothing to uncover the secrets here. The island fueled that hunger for knowledge. I had doubts about whether the ritual would work. But what happened to Cassandra cleared up those doubts. The ritual wasn't for people like you. The ritual was only for people like me. But you refused to believe it. Until the island itself spoke directly to you. Pacha Falgafen. She is our daughter. That's when you finally understood. You understood what my fate would be if I didn't come here and carry out the ritual. A slow and painful death. So you faked your own demise and left your glasses near Cassandra's corpse. Those same glasses you never take off. And you sent me the package from Dignity, Harry. Your picture, the key, the dagger. Another one of your scavenger hunts. And I took the bait. You made me come to this island, the same island where you almost lost your mind and your life. The same island where four members of your expedition perished. Why did you deceive me, Harry? You said you would never lie to me. Why didn't you tell me the truth? Why did you do this to me? Because you knew that I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. Right, my love? Not even if staying with you would mean a slow and painful death. So the only way to get me to leave you was to make me believe you were dead. And you chose to live a life without me, so I could be who I really am. That's why you tried to deceive me. But I know you too well, my dear old pal. We've had so many years together, so many moments of love, happiness, understanding, friendship, a whole beautiful life with you. I know what you tried to do, but I can't let you make this decision for me, Harry. Either I embrace my fate and accept what I've always been, and leave you behind. Or I reject it, and return home with you, to relish the time that my illness gives us. It's my decision to make. You were right about one thing, Harry. I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. I know who I really am and where I belong. I know fate has eternal life in store for me, but an eternal life without you is worthless, meaningless. So, I choose the slow and painful death. I'm going back home. You staged this ruse because you love me. But true love is reciprocal. So I'm also making this decision because I love you. Our love is greater than fate, lineage, or all the pain I can suffer. Whatever time we have left, we'll spend together. When the time comes, it will be your hand that holds mine. And those beautiful blue eyes will be the last thing I see before I leave.
So, you didn't find your husband on that island, Mrs. Everhart?
I did find my husband. He wasn't on the island, though.
But what have you been doing these 3 days? What did you find then?
I don't know. The truth about myself, I suppose. And at the same time, the reason to go back home.
I don't think I follow you.
Have you ever been in love, Captain Hodgson?
In love? You mean like in a romance novel?
No, that's fiction, Captain. In real life, true love stories don't end with a wedding. They end with a funeral. And the only thing that eases that final moment of heartbreaking sadness are all the good memories lived together.
Honestly, I don't think I've ever felt anything like that, Mrs. Everhart. But if you love your husband that much, he's certainly a lucky man.
We are both lucky.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
One, two, don't forget the harmony. One, two, three.
All my life is empty since I went away. Skies don't seem to be so clear. May some angel sentry guard you while I stray, and fate be kind to join us some sweet day. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night and day I pray you're always mine. Sweetheart, may God bless you.
Smile and your tender loving way. I just want you only, want you all the while. May God decree I have you back someday. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal. Each night and day I pray you're always mine. Sweetheart, may God bless you.
Honey, are you all right?
I'm fine, Harry, don't worry. I can keep going.
No, listen, let's leave it for today. You shouldn't make any unnecessary efforts.
Really, darling, I'm fine.
You need to rest, Nora. Come on, I'll take you to bed.
Even today, so many years later, I still doubt whether I did the right thing. In the end, it didn't matter. You returned home and forgave my deception. We moved close to the sea and had a few more good years, didn't we? Until you left me that one sunny March morning. I wish I could be reunited with you. But fate has punished me with a long and sorrowful life, with no other incentive than my work, because that is the only thing I have now, my dear old pal.